Hey everybody, I'm back a lot sooner than I thought I'd be. Went through all the bill of materials, the instructions for the boat, and managed to make sense of things a little bit more, and did a lot of cuts on the table saw. Nothing really new there from what I showed you last time. I do have a pile of sawn lumber, and there's Wonky here to help us all out. He's been doing a very good job at whatever it is that he does. And I was sawing up this mahogany here, and just really, really great lumber. I haven't really worked with anything like this before, but it just looks beautiful. And what I sawed was there's this piece here that's going to be is going to go into multiple cross pieces that go across the boat. So we'll look up here, and so you have these frames that go across, and they're the tops of the frames. So this piece right here and here, and not back here because you got to sit there. And anyway, so that piece is going to be sawn up into smaller bits that go across and are shaped accordingly. I can look at the instructions and try to show you a little bit of what it might be. So it's going to be those pieces that go across there. And all this takes a long time to figure out because, again, these instructions are very dense and don't do a lot to discuss the principles of building this boat. So, you know, all the words chine and shear, and it doesn't discuss what those are. You can look those up, but the shear line is the water line, I believe, and the chines are the sides, the angled sides on the boat. We have the stringers along the bottom, battens that go perpendicular to the stringers and run along them. They go through the frame pieces. You have these frame rails up here. They might be called frame rails or something. Oh, they call them deck beams is what they call them. So then there's the shear guard, which is which runs along this very top edge here. And let's see, keel is along the center of the boat, the center longitudinally along the center of the boat. Transom is, of course, the very rear piece, and you can see they have a solid piece of mahogany here. And there's just a bunch of little things like that that it takes a long time to sort through. And not to mention that you have to figure out dimensionally how much lumber is available to you and how exactly you're going to cut it. So it takes up a lot of time. What I'm doing right now, though, that I want to show you is I'm prepping what's going to be the transom and the dash. And the dash is simply, go underneath here real quick, and the dash is this piece right here that the steering wheel will attach to, and you'll have a gauge or two on there. And it's a solid piece of mahogany, half inch thick. And you have the transom back here, which again is a solid piece. In the instructions, I'm going to do a glue up and have two pieces of mahogany, half inch thick. What I have here, though, is a very long, very beautiful piece of mahogany that is just over an inch thick. And I don't really have any good way to resaw it and save about a half inch of the board. And so I end up having to plane it down, and that's I could have cut it up, because what I'm gonna end up doing, this is about a 11 inches wide. I'm gonna saw a piece 54 inches long and a second piece 54 inches long, glue those together. That's going to become the transom, and then there's going to be another piece that's about 20 inches long that's going to become the dash. And they only need to be a half inch thick. I don't need any other pieces. I managed to get everything that I needed out of another piece of mahogany that was a little bit wider that you see that here in front of you. Again, that's so I have, these are the chine strips that run along the upper, or sorry, these are the bottom chines that run along the bottom of the boat. And I don't know, there's a couple other pieces in there that the rest of the mahogany went to. But as you can see here, this is a really long board. I didn't want to cut it up, and it would be much more manageable to plane if it was shorter. But I'd have issues with snipe going into and out of the planer. And I really want to try to minimize that. And in order to minimize that and do away with the snipe as it goes into, you know, it's going to chew in a little bit more as it dives into the planer, and as it exits the planer, the board, you know, just a little bit more comes off. It's going to be really hard to do a glue up that looks good. So much better off planing this whole board down from 1 inch to about a half inch. I might leave it a little thick, but what I end up doing is, you know, I have an infeed roller and an outfeed roller, just aligning them, doing a test run through the planer with the planer off and the planer set high, so that I can just feed it through, make sure it balances well on the infeed roller, and that as it goes off the infeed roller, that it isn't tipping the planer one way or another. And when it hits the outfeed roller, that it's at a good height, and that when it reaches the very end, that it doesn't want to rock back and pull the planer up. So there's a little bit of setup there. There's going to be a lot of wood chips made from this. It's a little bit wasteful, but you know, given the stock that I have on hand, it's I think the best approach. And I don't need any more mahogany after this. And the other thing that I realized too is that, you know, the bill of materials is ultimately a suggestion, and you can make this whole thing out of pine if you wanted to. You could make it all out of mahogany if you wanted to. And I have a bunch of lumber sitting around, some really good black walnut that I might incorporate into it. There's some oak that I'm going to incorporate into it as well. And you know, it's just a matter of just realizing that the instruction isn't an exact recipe. It's the way the author made it. There's obvious flaws in it, typos and miscommunications. But even if everything was perfect, again, it just has to end up looking like a boat. It has to be watertight, and it has to float. And anything else, there's a lot you can do to deviate from that, and it'll still be a successful, good product at the end. So that's what I'm trying to keep in mind, just getting away from the following it as if it was a recipe. So that's the latest update. Hopefully by the end of today, I will have all of my rough cuts done, and then it's a matter of gluing and screwing the frames together and really making a boat. So I'll keep you guys posted. Bye.